Look who decided to show up after an hour. Imagine being that late to a date and not letting your date know. Couldn't be me. You're lucky I'm patient and didn't have the gall to leave after you didn't answer my call, wondering where you were. Your phone died. How unfortunate. Well, your luck continues because I have a battery pack with me. Unlike you, I'm prepared for these sorts of situations. Here. No, I'm not being nice. Losing you in an aquarium without your phone would be a nightmare. I'd have to go to the reception and tell them I've lost a fucking child to try and find your easily distracted ass. Then, they'd have to announce over the PA that they're looking for you. Would you want the entire aquarium, including the fucking penguins, to know you are lost? Anyway, you should be more careful. What would have happened if you got stranded somewhere and you couldn't contact anyone?
Ugh. Ask a stranger to make a phone call.
Wow, why didn't I think of that? Didn't you learn stranger danger in primary school? Ugh, you're insufferable. Whatever. While I was waiting for you, I already lined up and got our tickets. So, it's not like I had anything better to do. Yes, yes, the time was for 15 minutes ago when we were meant to go in. But it's fine, we can go in now, it's not a big deal. What of it? Yeah, obviously I went and bought the tickets when I got here. Unlike you, I actually have the foresight to get shit done and not wait on others. Well, I didn't go home after an hour of waiting. Because I already bought the tickets by the time I realized you were going to be late, you smartass. You're insufferable. Whatever. This ditzy aquarium date was your idea, so can we head in and get this over and done with so I can go home? No, it wasn't our idea. It was yours specifically. Don't be stupid. Honestly, what am I going to do with you? Let's just go in. Yeah, yeah, the penguins are cute. Yes, I know it's adorable that they cuddle around when they get cold. Every kid in year 5 learns about it. What are you looking at me like that for? Cuddle? No, I said huddle, you idiot. Seriously. Use that head of yours. Ugh. Anyway, these are Gentoo penguins, for your information. Look, they're feeding them now. Hmm? Ah, oh, I know the name because I saw those penguins on the website when I was booking the... Never mind. Doesn't matter how I found out. It says over there, see? Yeah, whatever. Let's just... keep moving along. Yeah, I think the seahorses are pretty cute as well. Yeah, it is nice that the dad takes care of the babies. I remember when I was in year 2, we had to do this presentation on sea animals because we had this... we had this excursion to this aquarium, actually. It was pretty cool. So when we got back, we had to go do a presentation on the sea animals. And I remember I got so mad because one of the kids said, the male seahorse gives birth to the seahorse babies, which isn't true. The mum still gives birth to the seahorse babies, but she just gives them to the dad. Why do you look at me like that? Ugh, come on. I'm just trying to be funny and lighthearted. Whatever. Hey, what are you looking at that weird-ass corridor for? It says it's a passageway to a domed room where you can see the fish above you. You want to go in there, don't you? Okay, let's go in then. What? I'm assuming you want to go in there and see something lame and cheesy like that. Yeah, whatever, let's go. No, I don't care if we go in or not, that you're going to make a fuss about it if I don't let you go in. So to save my ears and my sanity, I'm going to take you into this stupid dome. Oh, you can see the fish swimming around in this corridor. Where the fuck did they? Hello? What are you doing? I am trying to appreciate the fish in this exhibit. What are you doing? Standing away. Yes, it's a narrow corridor. Yes, I know it can fit two people comfortably. But you can walk next to me like a normal fucking person. We're not strangers, you know. I thought you said this was a fucking date. Honestly. Hey, look over there. It's a black reef shark. Huh? How do I know that? God, because I've been reading the info that's scattered around here. My head isn't in the clouds like a certain person. A certain person that's getting very comfortable standing so close to me. I didn't tell you to move away though. You can stand closer. A little closer. Yeah, like that. Just stay there. You're impossible to deal with. Come on, let's keep walking together so we can get to that stupid dome. Whoa, this thing is actually pretty. What with the fish and sharks swimming above us? And look around. There's no one else here to disturb the peace. The peace? The peace and quiet, because it's just us two. Obviously, silly thing. Hey, look at that. It's a pair of manta rays. Look at their mouths. They make that same face you're always making. You know, the one you're always texting. The two dots for the eyes and the three for the mouth. That stupid face you're always ending your sentences with. They're making that face now. Oh, come on, don't look at me like that. If you want to be around me more, you'll have to put up with my shit. Oh, but I guess that means I have to put up with yours, doesn't it? I mean, you've been tolerable so far. So I guess I'm not too fussed. There's some seats in the middle there. Do you want to go sit down? Yeah, you can sit right next to me. I don't buy it, I promise. We can enjoy the view from here. Well, it looks like someone enjoyed themselves. What does it matter what I thought about it? The aquarium was your idea, you silly thing. I didn't hate it, if you must know. Why are you smiling like a dumbass? I said I didn't hate it. Yeah, whatever. It was all right. I only agreed to come along because it's summer and there's AC inside the aquarium. But I'm glad you had a good time. Next time, don't keep me waiting, and I'm sure we'll have a great time. Yes, I said next time. You're not that awful to be around, surprisingly. So I think I can tolerate more of you. Yeah, whatever. See you around, you silly thing.